Human activities have caused changes to our climate, but can we blame our disasters on climate change? Join me, Ilan Kelman, in this next episode of our series to find out why climate change cannot be blamed for everything. Climate change infuses many discussions about disasters today. By definition, climate measures weather statistics, usually over a few decades, and climate change is a change in these weather statistics. There is no question that human activity substantially affects the climate, and we are now witnessing these effects through swiftly changing weather. Today, we see large-scale, rapid changes due to significant human influence. Yet the definition of climate and these statements about climate change show that they are about hazards only. Disasters are caused by vulnerabilities, not hazards. It seems that neither climate nor climate change, by definition, can be or can cause a disaster. For a disaster to occur, vulnerabilities must be present, and they inevitably are. As the air warms due to climate change, heat waves and precipitation-related droughts become more likely, also affecting wildfires. We do not fully cope with today's heat, droughts, and wildfires while vulnerabilities are increasing. Thus, disasters will continue, but not due to climate change. Warmer air also holds more moisture, meaning more intense rainfalls. Again, without addressing existing storm and flood vulnerabilities, more and worse flood disasters can be expected under climate change. Increased heat and humidity will curtail outdoor agricultural work, while people and animals will require more water to stay healthy, increasing the likelihood of drought. Crops will suffer as evaporation rates increase, so we might need to substitute present ones with plants having different irrigation and tilling requirements. Higher temperatures make it harder to learn at school and to do homework at night, impeding education. Adding air conditioning or using fans boosts expenses and energy consumption. Although plenty can be done for cooling building interiors with traditional and modern architectural practices that encourage natural ventilation. Ultimately, without action on climate change, it looks as if large swaths of land will end up being too hot for working or learning, leading to large-scale mortality or migration. Heat waves in the future could be disasters caused by climate change, for which we have little comprehensive opportunity for reducing vulnerability. It might be the same if human-caused climate change leads the Greenland and Antarctic ice sheets to melt. In worst-case scenarios, over several centuries, seas would rise higher than a 20-story building, drowning around a dozen island countries and many coastal cities. Can we counter climate change as an influence of hazards? Yes, by stopping the major human influences on climate through two broad categories of actions, reducing greenhouse gas emissions and increasing their uptake. One major way of reducing greenhouse gas emissions is by reducing our energy consumption, especially our use of fossil fuels, healthier diets, more plant-based and focused on local resources. These will also cut greenhouse gas emissions. The uptake of greenhouse gases can be increased by measures including stopping forest destruction and restoring forest ecosystems. Interestingly though, all these actions should be implemented anyway for reasons other than climate change. Reducing consumption makes sense because resources including fossil fuels are finite, so we will need to wean ourselves off them anyway. Healthier diets, reduce healthcare costs, and improve our quality of life. As for forests, in addition to absorbing greenhouse gases, they help to keep our air and water clean while providing long-term opportunities for people to generate non-destructive livelihoods ranging from food to local tourism. Climate change adds a strong impetus towards these actions, yet so many other benefits accrue from them, particularly reducing vulnerabilities to all hazards and all hazard influencers. So are we immune to all disasters as long as we take measures to avoid them? Join me to find out whether there are exceptions to this general rule in the next episode of The Science of Disasters. Subscribe to the full series. hit the bell button to be notified when new downloads are available.